A very good evening, everybody. Thank you for joining us here today. We have in conversation with us today Meghna Pant, who's the author of The Terrible, Horrible, Very Bad Good News. Meghna Pant is a multiple award-winning author, a journalist, a feminist, and a speaker. She's also mom to two very young girls. Welcome, Meghna. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you, Pasna, for having me. Looking forward to this conversation.
Absolutely. Joining us, Neeti Palta, a most famous stand-up comedian. Neeti has been part of the comedy scene since its inception in India. With a writing background in advertising and TV, she draws influences from real-life experiences, humans, and our Indian innateness. If I was to go on to introduce these two lovely women, I would have to be here the whole time. But I would also like to say this book has been published by Penguin India. And this lighthearted read is soon to be seen as a major motion picture named Badnaam Laddu. This humorous yet inspiring story, I absolutely loved it, by the way, of a small town woman's fight against social stigma will resonate with all of you. So thank you so much for joining us today, ladies, and over to you.
Thanks, Upasana. Look forward to this. Welcome, Neeti. It's so nice to finally connect, even if it's just via Zoom.
Yeah, Meghna, it's been a while. Thanks, Upasana. And Meghna, first question I have for you, honestly, is you wrote this in the first lockdown.
Yes, and I had a one-month-old baby and a three-year-old. And I think, you know, anybody who's been following my work, I write very serious fiction. And I think I needed humor to throw my, you know, COVID life into sharp relief because there was so much, we know what it's been like, you know, around us. I mean, the tragedy that we've seen unfold. I think humor was the only thing that kind of helped me cope. And I think that, you know, people like you, comedians, have really been doing a great service of lifting up people's spirit very similarly. So I think I needed a book, you know, to lift my spirits, to lift my mood. And I wanted my readers also to get something that they deserve. Because I think we've all gone through enough over the last 14, 15 months. And I think a book like this is just something, it's a light, fun read. It'll just tickle, you know, your funny bones and it'll make you think, but without being pedantic or without being, you know, overbearing. And I've tried to make it as contemporary as possible with my Tamara, who's a millennial and all her influencer lingo. And, you know, Laddu, who's, I think the core of it is that, you know, we all, the biological clock and wanting a child, I think, which any woman would identify with, because especially in India, right? So that was the whole sort of logic behind writing a book with a sense of humor.
Actually, that's the funny part because I remember the first lockdown, I was so lost and you know, I would call up all the other comics and I didn't know what's going on. So, yeah, are you writing? Are you writing? Because I had a full-on writer's block. And then I remember thinking, 9 months mein log bacha bana dete, mere se ek special nahi likha gaya. And then I see this book on bacha, I'm like, man.
Yeah, but I thought I dared gay because I said, I hope people don't start comparing me to my brother, you know, Saurabh Pant, who's a professional comedian. I said, I'm not as funny as him. But Jitna, because, you know, we've been raised with a lot of sense of humor. My father is the funniest man you'll ever meet. Like, he has a joke for every occasion. So I feel like in comparison, my father is the funniest guy in the family, then my brother, and then maybe me. So I was like, I hope I'm not compared to Saurabh inevitably.
I'm surprised you managed to get any word in edgewise when Saurabh's in the room. But Matt, it's, you know, I was also laughing because in this, you know, she does consider getting her eggs frozen. Yeah. And I was just thinking, I can't understand the stigma attached to artificial insemination because, you know, all our lives, we are told stay away from boys. And then suddenly we are told.
I love that.
It is. Suddenly we are told, here's a complete stranger, go make babies with him. So I would imagine.
I love it.
It's true, right? I would imagine. Parents would love it that, you know, you've cut out the middleman altogether and gone and made babies on your own straight. I really don't understand the stigma.
And, you know, honestly, a man's contribution, even if I have a very hands-on, very devoted father, but I still feel like the contribution of the father is still only 10. It stops at, you know, the initial, the sperm, to put it a little candidly. And that's it. I mean, beyond that, honestly, I've told a lot of my friends who are single and they're wasting so much of their time trying to find the perfect guy, the perfect husband. I said, forget that. Just find the perfect sperm donor instead. You know, because they want to have kids, but they're stopping their own, you know, they're being gatekeepers to their own dream by looking for the perfect guy. I said, forget all that. Just find the perfect sperm donor and you're sorted. You don't need a guy for this to have a child. But, you know, we think like that. Say you're in Delhi, I'm in Mumbai. So I think we think like that. So I wanted to set this in a small town like Rishikesh, right?
Yeah, I love that. The dichotomy was fun. You know, Rishikesh, pure vegetarian, and then she's considering this.
Yeah, because I feel like people in small towns, because I'm from a small town originally. I was born in Shimla and my parents are, you know, from Shimla and Nainital. And they were with the government. So they've moved around, you know, to Surat and similar like small towns. So I have been exposed to that a lot. And people there are very different from what I've seen in Mumbai, where I've grown up for most of my life. I feel like people have more time to like really feel things, you know, whether it's good or bad or, you know, even judgmental or even to show you their love. They really tap into their feelings. So there, they also have time to be scandalized. I think places like Bombay, though, nobody has time to be shocked about anything. Yeah. Time in here.
That's actually true. And I have one question, okay, because I was massively scarred by that scene. So I have to ask you, okay?
Yeah.
So guys who've not read the book yet, please read it. Okay, there's a baby shower happening. And one of the games in the baby shower is, I mean, people are given nappies and there's like mixed food product in the nappy, which people are supposed to taste and say, kya kya hai wo? Huh. So, does this actually happen at a baby shower or were you smoking something when you wrote that?
No. So, the first baby shower I ever attended was, and by the way, I was terrible with like managing kids and all that. I'm not one of those, you know, naturally maternal people. So, I went to a baby shower in Dubai when I was living there. And I remember that melted chocolate, Ferrero Rocher and all the fancy, milti. So, it was a melt karke. And I won that game because I'm obsessed with chocolate. So I know every chocolate flavor, okay?
Right.
And then when I came to India, my friends threw me two baby showers both the time for both my kids. And again, the same game was being played. So, you know, it's actually like, it's just, and, but yahan pe laddu wagera karte hain diapers mein, you know, melt anything brownish to be, yeah. People were tasting it, by the way. They weren't just smelling it, by the way. They were actually licking it and tasting it to see ki, kya hai wo, you know, kaun sa flavor hai.
I have a habit of snacking when I read a book, okay? You've ruined that experience for me forever. Thank you so much.
But Neeti, after changing diapers, I've just been changing diapers over the last 4 years. You just become immune to anything. Abhi mujhe kuch bhi dikha do, I have no reaction, only because, you know, changing diapers just, you know, makes you very strong, I think, against any kind of icky sights and smells also. So that was quite fun.
Just a fun anecdote. I remember we were doing Comic Stunt season 2.
Yeah.
And there was one like a improv kind of a show where we were doing the most shocking things you can say at a baby shower.
What came up?
Dude, the fun part is kids say, someone took a literal this thing, oh, bacche ki aankh mein saboon ja raha hai. And then somebody went somewhere, somebody, and finally one of us said, guys, baby shower mein baby actually hota nahi.
Seriously. I know. But you know, for somebody jiske paas bacche nahi hai, it's very intimidating baby shower mein jana. Or you know, people are very judgmental for some reason if you don't know things, especially the expectant mother. So those incidents I described, ki usko, you know, she didn't know ki pump kaise hota hai, ya baby langot, you know, like how, like a onesie, or how does it all work? How does it all come together? I remember my husband and I, the first time we went to a baby store, mother care, we were like, we got trauma, and we consider ourselves fairly intelligent people. We went into depression for a day. We were like, we are not prepared for this. We didn't understand one product in that shop. So, you know, man, we were little, if you're a new parent or expectant parent, it's very intimidating. Yeah. Ki, you know, it's like a whole new world. Yeah, so I wanted to capture that in that baby shower scene, basically.
So tell me one thing, like you must have done some research on, you know, having eggs frozen and stuff. Because I remember, and I'm talking about a couple of years ago, it came in the newspaper that Google and Facebook are, you know, now considering or offering to freeze their female employees' eggs so that the female can keep working and not worry about the biological clock. And I had come up with a whole series of jokes on how India mein ye nahi chalega. How do you tell neighbor auntie who comes, koi good news hai, nahi auntie, maine apne ande jama diye.
फ्रीजर में डाल दे वो
सो हाउ पॉपुलर इज इट और हाउ प्रेवलेंट इज दिस लाइक व्हाट वाज योर रिसर्च
सो बेसिकली एक्चुअली आई वाज लड्डू सो आई वाज दैट यू नो 34 ईयर ओल्ड डिवोर्स गर्ल हु यू नो आई लिव्ड अराउंड द वर्ल्ड आई सर्वाइव्ड एन अब्यूसिव मैरिज आईड वन अवार्ड्स आईड रिटन बुक्स एंड येट लाइक एवरी टाइम आई गो समवेयर पीपल विल बी लाइक शादी नहीं की बच्चे नहीं है और तुम्हारी बस निकल गई अब यू नो अभी तो इट्स टू मतलब इफ यू क्रॉस 32 इन इंडिया इट मीन्स यू विल नेवर हैव किड्स एंड आई एक्चुअली स्टार्टेड फीलिंग लाइक अ फेलियर लाइक एज अ वुमन कि अनलेस आई हैव किड्स मतलब मेरा कोई पर्पस ऑफ लाइफ ही नहीं है यू नो आई एम टेलिंग यू वेरी ऑनेस्टली सो आई एक्चुअली वेंट टू अ फर्टिलिटी डॉक्टर हु माई फ्रेंड हैड यूज फॉर IVF एंड आई वॉज गोइंग टू फ्रीज माई एग्स बट ही टोल्ड मी द सेम थिंग ही सेड इट्स वेरी लेट फॉर यू though your fertility is okay and he said ki it's better to use a donor so you know that I think that seed was planted then but then fortunately literally the next year I met a lovely wonderful man Sahil and we fell in love got married and I said the first thing I said abhi se start kar do bachcha paida karna hai jaldi se but you know because I was not expecting to get pregnant but Neeti I got pregnant at the age of 36 I popped out my first kid at 37 and I had a miscarriage in between the two kids but then I again got pregnant at 39 actually 38 and got had my second baby at 39 so you know I feel like yaar sab jo hame darate hain na auraton ko ki your biological clock is ticking and none of those fears came true so I said everything that we've been taught since we were little girls ki bacche jaldi paida karo and that's why you must get married early was that a big fat lie so you know, I want to just debunk all these stereotypes that first of all women don't have to have kids you have kids only if you want to because trust me it is so much work You really better really want, you know, you better be prepared to be a mother if you want to be. I mean, don't do it just because society is telling you. And secondly, do it on your own terms. There's so many ways of having kids now. So yeah. I found all this out, you know, once I visited doctors, ki apart from IVF adoption, you can use an egg donor if you're older and your eggs have, you know, don't really function anymore. There's so many ways to experience pregnancy or to experience having a kid of your own, surrogacy, whatever it is. So, you know, don't beat yourself up if you're a certain age and people are telling you things. Just do it on your own terms. It's your body, your choice.
You know, what I find ironic is, like, you wanted to have kids, right? And your protagonist wants to have kids and society is judging her because she's a single mom who wants to have kids.
Yeah.
What's ironic is, like, you know, if there is actually a lady who's married and her whole ambition in life, just as, like, okay, even if she's not married, but her whole ambition is she wants to get married to a nice man, have nice kids, you know, take care of a nice house, home, be a homemaker. We still judge her. So no matter what she decides, either way we are going to judge her. Might as well do what you want.
Might as well. You'll be judged. Even if you have one kid, they'll be like second bachcha nahi hua. When you have a second kid, they'll be like third bachcha nahi hua. You'll be judged no matter what you do. So you might as well just do things on your own terms to begin with, you know. Never listen to what people have to say about your life. Just, you know, exercise your choice. Do what I really wanted to be a mother. So I was very clear that कुछ भी करके मैं अडॉप्ट भी करना जो भी करना आई वांटेड टू बी वन बट सो मेनी ऑफ माय फ्रेंड्स डोंट एंड दे हैव ग्रेट लाइफ्स दे ट्रैवलिंग मसाई मारा वाला आई एम डाइंग ओवर हियर ब्रेस्टफीडिंग फॉर एटर्निटी सो यू नो आई मीन देयर इज डिफरेंट वेज टू लिव लाइफ देयर इज नो लाइक यू नो बॉक्स दैट यू वी ऑल हैव टू फिट इनटू सो जस्ट I think that was the whole mess. Because Tamara, our Laddu sister, she didn't want to have kids.
Yeah.
And you know, but she still respects her sister's choice that she wants to have kids. But at the same time, there's so much mutual respect that we understand where you're coming from. That if you want to have kids, I respect that. If you don't want to have kids, we respect that equally. So, you know, I think that mutual respect, especially between women, we have to lift each other up. So I think that was the whole, I wanted to capture that in the relationship between the two sisters. And I love their relationship. I wish I had a sister.
I actually love the whole family, you know. I could actually understand where the mother was coming from.
Yeah.
I could literally visualize the father in my head saying, ki, achha, I will support you as long as society ko nahi pata chale. But later also, you know, he is like, you know, it takes time, right, to for them to adjust to our times and stuff. We keep changing the goalposts and expect everybody to fall in place. Time lagta hai. I love the bua. I love the whole bua and mother sharing the drink in the evening. So, you know, typically books bring alive, you know, characters in your head and stuff. And I personally believe half the times the movies disappoint me because the books have painted an image in my own head, right, which I've created. Yeah. So who do you see playing your protagonist? Like Laddu, who do you see?
Oh, that's such a good question. So the book is going to be, actually, this was a very interesting journey because this started out as a screenplay and I wrote it as a screenplay. Yeah, so it was picked up by a production house as a story. And then I, on my own free will, wrote it as a screenplay because I really loved the story. I loved the characters. And I'm very like OCD. I didn't want any other writer to come in and take over my story. I'm like, pata nahi kya kuch bana denge. So I said, main hi karti hu ye story. Mujhe hi likhni hai aur koi nahi likhega isko. And then after writing the screenplay, the novelist in me kicked in. I said, yeah, this is a very good idea for a novel also. So then I converted it into a novel. And then it was amazing the reception because Penguin immediately picked it up. Then Audible has brought out an audiobook. This is the first of my books that's been picked up for a Hindi translation as well. So, you know, it's going to go into most of India. So I'm so excited about that. And this is my seventh book, by the way, the only one that's been picked up. So I'm very excited about that. And again, it's going to be made into a movie. And I think, I don't know, like there have been so many actors, I think, that can play this role very well because it's a role that any woman will identify with, right? So like I see Tapsee Pannu or Bhumi Pednekar, even Kiara Advani. By the way, everyone thinks it's Kiara Advani.
I swear, the cover. Ladies, does this not look like Kiara? It does.
It does, right? I know. I think it was coincidental. Maybe my... I love the designer, by the way. I think Akanksha Sharma, she did such a brilliant job. I've never liked any of my book covers instantly. This was the first... I saw it and I'm like, do not change one thing about this cover. It is brilliant.
Yeah.
So even someone like Pariniti, I think Sania Malhotra, Sonakshi, there's so many people I can think, Kriti Sanan, who can play this role and play it well. But Tamara, somehow I feel like Ananya Pandey or... You know, something like that would really do justice to this role.
And I was thinking Ratul Preet also.
Ratul Preet, yes. Oh yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And Kamini Kavya, I just thought of Nusrat Bharucha. I don't know why. I feel like she really fits that into that role, doesn't she?
Yeah, she does. Actually, I was thinking older. So like thinking, you know, Laddu being Huma Qureshi, because she also have, come to that body image issues and stuff. You know, Tamara being like a Rakul, because imagine the difference between the two would be visible right there.
That's
right.
True.
And you would know, oh, this is why the sister has image issues, etc. And I was thinking, who do you see 4'10"?
Oh my God. Have you watched The White Tiger?
Yeah.
So Adarsh Gaurav, who's the protagonist. I don't know. I can't see anybody else as 4'10 except him. I just can't. I don't know. Unless you have other ideas. For me, like somehow, I see him as playing 4'10 very well.
Actually.
Yeah. Unless, I don't know. Can you think of anyone else? Because I just thought that 4'10, you know, like he captures him pretty well.
I might mess up on the names because I'm really bad. But the guy who played Newton, Rajkumar.
Oh, I love Rajkumar. Of course. Yeah.
You know,
he would
brilliant.
Also be really good. Actually,
he's
you're
brilliant.
Right. He would be. Actually, I was thinking of Rajkumar even at Sandeep Oberoi. Although I want to cast Hrithik Roshan because he's so hot. And I want Hrithik Roshan in every movie. I want to see him in every movie. I don't know why he's not in every
shirtless
movie.
Sandy. Can I be there when
shirtless
you're casting?
Sandy. I want to be there when they're casting Shirtless Sandy also.
That's what I'm saying. I really want to be there. I want to cast my vote or my eyes, whatever. Sorry, guys, if this is getting sexist. Thoda si hoon. So... But you know what, something important in here was, you know how you touch upon every issue in a woman's life, but in such a non-preachy way. Like you have a protagonist who has body issues, like I'm too plump, she's perpetually on a diet. You know, we guys, come on, you know,
We do this every day, don't we?
We do it all the time. We will click a photo. I have friends. When we do a group photo, all of us then are zooming in on our own picture in that photo.
And we never look at anyone else.
No. And then going, oh, why am I looking like this? No, take again. Nahi, mera angle theek nahi tha. That voice in our heads is the only one that puts us down as much as, like nobody puts us down as much as we do.
Yeah, own worst critics. I've given birth to two kids at almost 40. And I'm constantly criticizing my body. And I'm like, why am I doing this? I have a healthy body that was able to conceive at such a late age.
Yeah.
And give me healthy, happy kids. And I've been, you know, this dialogue in my head constantly going on that stop it, stop it. You know, be body positive. And I haven't met a single woman, including the most beautiful, by the way, I've met some, you know, even Bollywood ladies who are so drop dead stunning. And I haven't met a single woman till today who's happy with her body.
It's true.
And you've got the most perfect body. So I'm like, again, it's the same thing because, you know, we are our own worst critics when it comes to our body. And I think I wish we would just stop doing that to ourselves. But it's very tough. I know it's very easy to preach it, but you know, jab hamare upar aata hai, we are not able to do it for ourselves also.
But you know, I don't even know whose perfection are we trying to match. I really don't get it.
I think Deepika Padukone, and probably if you meet her, she'll also not have something to say, complain about how beautiful she is. But yeah, I think we need to change the conversation because, you know, that's why I like Tamara, because Tamara is so confident. She's so happy with her own skin.
Yeah.
She has no issues. She's very happy with who she is. She's very bindas.
Right.
And I wish we could all be like that, you know, just own who you are and be happy with who you are. So, yeah.
See, that's one thing I loved about your book because your characters were very real. You know, you could see what makes them tick. I could visualize them. I could literally visualize their voices in my head. I loved the family, the protagonist family.
Yeah.
And even Kamini Kavya had her own reasons for being Kamini, right? Like, I love the, like, you know, she's like how exhausting it is to maintain herself.
Yeah.
You know, that also. So somewhere in my head, I was seeing Tisca for some reason.
Oh yeah, Tisca would be very good in that role. She'd be
excellent. She's very classy.
Very classy, yeah.
And she can be really bitchy. Sorry, Tisca. Like...
I've actually interviewed her once and she's so sweet. I love her. She's adorable. But yeah, she'd play the role very well. You're absolutely right. You know, I feel like all of us are trying to be superwomen so much.
Mm.
Like we all want to like earn as much as Indra Nooyi and look like Deepika Padukone and, you know, be as motherly as say Nirupa Roy or whatever. Like we're striving for so much perfection all the time. And I feel like feminism that way has been a disservice to us in certain ways because now we have to do everything. So, you know, and we have to be good at everything now. So I think that is something I want to take away from, you know, stop trying to be a superwoman. Yeah. Just we are all fundamentally flawed. We have failed so many times and it's good to fail and fall and just be completely imperfect, you know, be your perfect imperfect. So I think that was why I cast all the characters as, you know, perfectly imperfect.
That's beautiful.
That was fun.
That is beautiful. Actually, yeah, as they say, you know, to be if a guy does like bare minimum, oh, wow, what a wonderful dad he is. Mother spread herself out and she's a mom.
My husband just has to take the kids down for a walk and everybody's applauding him for like a week. And I'm taking them har roz mein leke jaati hu, subah shaam, 90% kaam main hi karti hu. And nobody's applauding me. They're like, this is part of your, you know, being a mother. So grow up. You're not allowed to complain if you're a mom. There's like this halo around your head.
Yeah, and if a mom annoying. Actually if complains or says something like which she genuinely means about her child, like, what a horrible woman.
Yeah, you cannot say anything. Yeah, it's a bit. So the superwoman thing has to stop. I think that's the next conversation we feminists need to have.
I actually look forward to your next book. I would love to see. And please don't give up on humor. Trust me, you're very good at it. And guys who've not read the book, it was such an easy breezy read. Like, I can't tell you, in this pandemic, you know, I went back to reading because, you know, OTT had taken over.
Yeah.
And I literally finished it within one or two sittings. I have three dogs that disrupt my life all the time. So I had to go play ball with them. But I'm telling you, 2 days, I was like so happy with this book. I'm loaning it to my mom. But I told her, listen, I want the book here so I can hold it up to my screen. I'll give it to you afterwards.
Thank you so much, Neeti. That's very sweet of you.
I really did love it.
Thank you. I hope the movie also comes out soon. I think things have been a bit delayed, but we will hope. I'm dying to see it on screen. I'm very excited about, you know, it reaching a very, very large audience because I think people are going to love this movie.
I think so too. I really do.
Yeah. And we all deserve it after what we've gone through, honestly.
Oh, yeah.
It's been a terrible time. Yeah.
That was so lovely, guys. I have Shweta Verma and Shalu Sharma online who are laughing their heads off and enjoying this conversation. So stay tuned, thank guys. You. We haven't finished. And Shweta says, Laddu is such a nice name.
I agree. I totally agree.
Isn't it? And Neha Goyal says, having kids due to societal pressure is a complete no-no.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Just do it only if you really want. It's a lot of hard work. My God. You but have to do it only if you really want it.
If you do have a baby out of societal pressure, you know that neighbor auntie who's like good news cup scenario, have the baby and then make her the babysitter and you go live your life.
Seriously, yeah.
We so wish we could do that, right? That
would be awesome. But I'm so bad. I've moved into the same building as my mother so that she can babysit and she absolutely hates me. My mother's like ready to disown me. So Saurabh also tried this stunt. We tried to pawn off his kids on me and I was like, yeah, nice try. But I in turn have pawned off my kids. And my mother was a working mother, right? So she has always grown up that if you want to work, you know, you must not feel guilty and all that. So I've taken it to the next level. I'm like, I refuse to feel guilty about working. My mom is there in the building. So, and by the way, Amara, Laddu is her pet name. Amara is her real name. So even in my first novel, 1.5 Wife, the protagonist was named Amara and I'd written it 12 years ago. And I said, wow. If I ever have a daughter, I'm going to name her Amara. So my firstborn is Amara. So all my novels, the protagonist is Amara. But I think now that I've had a second daughter, I need to start changing the name because she's going to be like, what is this favoritism?
What's your second daughter's name?
Arya. So I was addicted to Game of Thrones when I was, when I found that I'm pregnant and I went on Rohan Joshi's that final, you know, season finale.
Right.
And I kept talking about Arya and I found out the next day that I'm pregnant. So I said, if I have a girl and I was praying for another girl, I love girls. I want to raise like cool, fun, strong girls. So I was praying for another. I don't think I wouldn't have known what to do with a boy. So I was dying to have a second girl. So... Oh, yeah.
Put her name in one of your books as a middle child. And not going to go down well.
I know, I need to very quickly.
Yes, please. She will find out. Trust
me. She will find out. Yeah, she's not going to be pleased.
I know. I can just imagine the feeling. Thank you so much, ladies. This has been a wonderful, wonderful conversation, really. I also have one of our members online, Meena Auntie. She lives in Dehradun and she says most of us have an illusory attachment to egoistic image of ourselves, which holds us from extending so much we have and can offer.
Right. That's
which
true.
Is so true, which is so true, really. Thank you so much, Meena Aunty. And ladies, thank you so much for tuning in and watching. And I can't leave this conversation without thanking Penguin India. And don't forget to pick up the copy, your copy of this book, The Terrible, Horrible, Very Bad Good News. I'm saying it slowly so I don't miss out any
text. I had a lot of fun coming up with this title, by the way. Yeah. After Badnaam Laddu.
Terrible, horrible, very bad good news. I've always found it funny that people call it good news because when the lady finds out that she's pregnant, her first reaction is to throw up.
I did that, yeah. Oh God, and pregnancy is tough. They have all kinds of, you know, no halo effect. They all the hemorrhoids and the varicose veins. Oh, it's awful. Oh my God, yeah.
And don't forget the breastfeeding after. That's no walk in the park. So
I have a 16.5-month-old and she's still breastfeeding because she's a pandemic baby and I'm available to her 24/7 and I'm fed up. I was like my first one weaned off by herself after a year.
Right.
And I threw a party. I was like, I'm finally free. I'm not a cow anymore. This udder, I call it the udder phase of my life, right? My udder phase is not going to go on. I'm ready for it to be over.
It'll happen. I'm sure it'll happen.
Soon enough.
Amazing, Meghna, that you managed to write and
have seriously, hats off.
I have a very tolerant husband and my poor mother, long suffering mother.
I do hope you'll come back and maybe we can do a preview of the trailer of Badnaam Laddu.
Mm. Absolutely.
When it's out, and I really hope theaters open because we would love to see this movie. I mean, we'll make sure our members come and watch.
You know,
they would definitely relate to it, no doubt. I think there's something for all ages in this book. It's not that it's only for moms or anything. I think
Everyone
can absolutely relate to this book, no doubt about it.
Thank you, Aparna. That's so sweet of you to say.
Not at all. My pleasure. I really did enjoy the book. You know, even some of the dialogue stayed with me. So
thank you.
Hilarious.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you.
I agree with what Neeti said. Don't give up on humor.
Yeah, thank you. I'm so happy to hear that. So my next book is a serious book, serious literary novel, Boys Don't Cry, which is actually very from my personal story. But the one after that is a young adult novel, which is again with humor. Again, it's a screenplay that I'm converting to a book. So wow. That's also, it's kind of along the same writing
really
style.
Prolific, man.
I'm obsessed. Wow. I'm a workaholic. I feel like I've grown up with this middle class guilt that if I'm not working all the time, I don't deserve, you know, my khana peena also. So I've seen my parents constantly working. So I think it's just deeply, even Saurabh is like that. He's a workaholic.
Oh yeah.
So I think he's just grown up. Yeah, he's a total worker. He's worse than me also, I think. So yeah, we're a workaholic sibling couple. Yeah.
But I really hope there'll be a day when we can have you live at an event of ours. That would be lovely. Neeti, you're just next door. So that's very doable.
Maybe. I do have to say this though. Yes, that because I like the book so much, in your honor, I just didn't wear a nice top and, you know, just shorts underneath. I have taken the time and trouble to wear a full dress, guys.
Oh, wow. Very pretty dress. Thank you, Neeti. That's so sweet of you. You dress. You're looking very pretty.
So are you.
As always. Thank you.
I'm sure our Gurgaon Moms members will really appreciate that effort, Neeti.
A round of applause. Well done. Yeah. But when you're doing your shows and stuff nowadays, like, do you have to dress up or it's just the same office outfit?
Shirt, no, if it's a corporate show, I'll dress up.
Yeah.
Like, but I have, just for kicks, you know, you'll wear a formal top and then just like some shorts.
Shorts and yeah. We've all been doing that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good, good.
Awesome. Yeah. So thank you so much again, Meghna, Neeti, for joining us today. Thank you, Prateek and Penguin India, for bringing this book to us. And everyone who's watching, thank you for joining us. Do stay tuned to the Gurgaon Moms Facebook page, as well as our website for important updates. And the main thing is stay safe, stay home, get vaccinated, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you. Thanks for having us, Vipassana. Neeti, thank you so much. I know we've postponed this event a couple of times because of the pandemic. You've been very patient and very kind. And thank you so much. You're really a sweetheart. And Vipassana, it's lovely meeting you. And hopefully we'll catch